Well, we are back with your email questions. We want to continue to encourage you. Wasn't that an encouraging story of our CBN employee, Katie?
I am so proud of her.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we want to encourage you some more by answering your email questions on health and fitness.
We Clarissa, have about 1,000 employees, and she's one of them.
Exactly. And that's just 1,000 employees here, you know, because we've got people all around the world.
A couple thousand around. We don't tell the Indians to fast. They probably don't have enough food as it is.
That's true. All right. Well, Clarissa writes in and she says, I'm an elementary school teacher. About a month into the school year, I usually get a cold and sore throat. Do you have some suggestions for how I can head off at the pass this year?
Well, Clarissa, the big thing you've got to do is, I know those little children are sweet, but the way they got more nasty things on them, they, you know, you've got to wash your hands three or four times a day and keep your hands out of your face. Just don't do it. If you've got to touch, handle, it's germs everywhere. All right, take vitamin C complex with the bioflavonoids, about 2,000 or 3,000 milligrams a day. Take zinc, about 50 milligrams once a day. And take lots and lots of vitamin D. You can go to 5,000, 10,000 units of vitamin D. It won't hurt you. And so those zinc, D, and C will help you, but wash your hands frequently.
And get plenty of rest. Because if I don't get a lot of rest, then your immune system kind of gets knocked down a little bit, and you're more susceptible.
That's good.
All right, Sherry writes in, and Sherry says, my son and a friend banged heads while playing basketball the other day. Over the next 24 hours, I watched them for symptoms of a concussion, but they seem fine. Do I need to be concerned beyond the 24 hours?
You sure do. You don't know when the results of this may take. There's so many young people now, I'm trying to think of the percentages, but a high percentage of young athletes wind up with concussions. You need to have them checked by a doctor before you get them back playing again, because if they get hit the second time, it may do permanent damage. So don't just say, well, because they seem to be okay.
Exactly.
Yeah. Look for symptoms. I mean, drowsiness, irritability, you know, forgetfulness and all these things. All right.
Exactly. And listen, if you want more information, we have an article on concussions on our website. All you have to do is just log on to CBN.com, click the Bring It On Extra link, and there you'll find some extra information. Because the brain is one thing you do not want to play with. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. Well, especially with the youngsters, their brains don't heal as fast as adult athletes. But even so, you know, there was one player, he got banged up in the head, and he sat on the bench, and they said, oh, he's okay. They put him back in the game, and the next thing you know, he's permanently paralyzed.
Wow.
So it's very serious, very serious.
That is scary. Well, Kara writes in, and Kara says, when I wake up in the morning, I often have neck and back pain. My husband thinks it's because I sleep on my stomach. Is there a sleeping position that's better for your body?
Well, according to the experts, sleeping on your back with no pillow is the best, or a very small pillow. I couldn't do that, but that's supposed to be the best for you.
How do you sleep? Stomach, side, back?
Side.
Do you?
Primarily. But I don't use pillows. I mean, I've got a little teeny pillow, a little teeny one, and I beat that up. So, I mean, it's you know, I don't want one. But, you know, but some people, they have these pillows and it puts them up in an unnatural position and chokes them up, and they think that's good for them. But in any event, I'm sorry, they're just too much. The Sleep Number, there's Tempur-Pedic, there are all these various mattresses, and they all have different claims. But a lot of times, if you've got back problems, you ought to check your mattress and see if you can't get another one.
Exactly.
All right.
James writes in and says, I often crave sweet snacks in the afternoon, and my coworker suggests that it was a sign of blood sugar imbalance. Do you think cravings can actually be related to specific health problems?
No, I think it's a result of eating too much sweets to start with, and it runs your adrenals and makes you crave more. And what your body is craving is not sweets. The body wants protein. And if you can get some protein snacks, whether it's soy nuts or whether it's a shake with whey protein or something like that you could take in the afternoon, or you can get there are any kinds of high protein bars with you can read the numbers. I mean, they go as high as 36, 37 grams of protein per bar. And you eat one of those, and it'll level you right out. So that's what you ought to do. Mm-hmm. But don't look for some underlying sickness. You're eating too much sweets, and that's causing the problem.
Exactly. That's a good point. I remember going, remember Dr. Sears?
Yeah.
I went to lunch with him when he was a guest on the 700 Club, and he was saying how...
The Zone Diet.
Yeah, the Zone Diet. I was trying to think of what he did. Uh-huh. And he was talking about a balance, and he hit the nail right on the head. He was talking about how if you do have something sweet, you have to counteract it with protein.
Yeah.
And I wish I remembered the why behind it, but...
He wants fat, too. You want all three.
Yeah. Protein. It just kind of balances you out.
But high glycemic carbs will do this to you, so stay away from high glycemic carbs. Don't eat candy, don't eat cookies, don't eat various types of sweets like that, and they set up a craving. That's just the way your body works.
Exactly. Okay.
All right.
Jonah writes in and says, my mom has all the risk factors for a possible heart attack, stressed, overweight, doesn't exercise. She thinks she's fine since she's never had any chest pain, but aren't the symptoms for heart attack different from women?
Yes, they are different. Mm-hmm. Men are much more... acute in their women don't have extreme pain, but they have they'll have weakness, shortness of breath, perspiration, things like that. But men have much more heart pain than women. So if you start having any of those symptoms, don't gut it through and think you're tough. Get to the doctor, have him check your heart.
Yeah, that's true.
All right.
Okay. Brett says, I'm a 26-year-old actor and recently noticed my hair is thinning. I don't want to go bald. Is there anything I can do to prevent or slow my hair loss?
Pray. I don't know what you could do. You can massage it. You can take various preparations to activate the hair follicles. But usually this is genetic. And if you start losing hair, I'm sorry. Get a piece.
I know. What? Get a piece. That threw me. I didn't expect that one. Well, you know, there's a supplement. And the reason why I know the supplement is because I just bought it. It's called biotin. And it helps you with, it's supposed to, you know, with hair, with skin, and with nails. Mm. And I start taking it because I had, just a little thin around the edges, and I wanted it to grow. I'm not saying I'm going bald. I just wanted, I like my hair being luxurious and shiny.
MSM makes it luxurious and shiny. MSM, it's horrible tasting stuff.
MSM.
But one teaspoonful of those crystals per day in a glass of juice or just by themselves will make your hair come out luxurious and full.
Really? At first I thought you said M&M's. I was like, really? I can do M&M's.
M-S-M.
Okay.
All right. I'll tell you a story.
Me a story.
Yeah. Some years ago, I was working with my friend Harold Bredesen in a little church in Mount Vernon, New York. Mm-hmm. Well, Harold, as you know, was almost bald and a real fun guy. So Pat Boone was shooting a story of Dave Wilkerson called The Cross and the Switchblade. They were doing a movie on that.
I remember seeing that movie.
So Pat's on the phone with Harold, and he said, Harold, I need a favor. And Harold said, what's that? He said, I'm noticing I'm losing a little hair, and I've got to play this role, and I need God to do a miracle and help me grow hair. Would you pray for me? And Harold said, I'll pray for no such thing. He didn't have any hair in his head.
But it was funny.
And so anyway. Years ago. Okay.
Lovely story, Pat.
Lovely story.
So he's asking the bald man to pray for him for hair.
Asking the bald man to pray for hair.
Didn't work.
For a little fringe, where is it? But in any event, whatever Pat's doing, it looks good. He looks younger than all of us.
I like the advice of buy a piece, get a piece, put a piece on.
That's right.
Works for me.